Hi, welcome to our channel again. Now in this tutorial, I would like to show you on how to install and use a PathAuto module. PathAuto is a very nice module for serving as your purpose. Now as it points out here, the PathAuto module automatically generate URL aliases for all kinds of content types, taxonomy terms, and uses based on that pattern. As you can see here, this is a beautiful path generated by pattern. Alright? We will go through several interesting patterns, especially for different content type, special pattern for basic page based on its menu link, pattern based on term reference field, and taxonomy term itself. PathAuto requires token module as well. That means we need to install two modules. Let's get started. Now first, we come to this PathAuto module page. Scroll down. Right hand click on your mouse and copy the link. Back to our site. Go to module, install new module. Paste the link here and click install. Now we need to install another module called token. So we install another module. Go to token module page, scroll down, copy the link back to our site and paste the link here, click install. Let's enable newly added modules, close it code, go down, let's enable PathAuto and token modules. Save configuration. Let's go to the configuration page. Configuration. Search and metadata. URL aliases. And click. Now as you can see, there are several new tabs added here where you can configure for the paths. Let's take a look at the settings. There are many settings where you can do here to adjust the path as you like. You can also add any other words that you want it to be stripped from the URL. I usually keep it as it is. Let's go to patterns. Here is the main page to configure the patterns. This is the default pattern path. It says it applies to all content type with blank patterns below. That means if you leave the pattern empty, then it will use a default one. Let's change the default pattern as I usually do. Replace content with content types pattern. You can find the token down below. There are many patterns you can explore. Now let's go to notes. Scroll down. Look for content type. Click on this link. It will automatically fill it up for you. Now after replacing with content type, scroll down and save the configuration. Let's create an article and see. Click content, add content, article. Fill in the title. And some dummy tags. Scroll down and click save. Now as you can see, the path generated here is using exactly the default pattern that we set on the setting page. He used a content type's name as we define. Let's go back to the pattern page. You can use Coffee module to enter the page by clicking Alt D. Type in pattern and press enter. Now pattern for all basic page paths. We often use menu links pattern so that it will take the patterns of the menu link and add them to the path. Let's click on the input field and find the pattern. Go down, open the replacement pattern. Click on notes, menu link, parents, plural, parents, join path. Click on the link, go to the top, and it fills up for you. Let's add the note title slash and key in note column title. Scroll down and click save configuration. Let's go back to the front page. As you can see, there's a multi-level menu on the left sidebar here, and each menu linked to its own basic page. Let's take a look at the company profile page. Path has not been updated to the latest. Since we have just changed the pattern, let's edit and update the path. Click Edit, scroll down, go to URL path settings, check Generate Automatic URL Areas, and click Save. Now you can see the new path. It has included and joined all the parents into the path. It's awesome. That's what we want. So let's proceed to the next.